All right, Sasha, we're going to try and learn your language. Bristag, what is that? It's a thing, something around here? Bristag, it means starship, doesn't it? Laysfa. Everything is safe, is that it?
Tonki ba non tontek.
You sleep there. Laysfa means sleep?
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
The starship. You mean home. The ship is your home.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
Say something else, Sasha.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Esawan?
Dong abuk shami no nok.
I need to hear more.
Dong abuk shami no nok.
So you're hiding. Na Esawan is hide.
Dong ki ba non tontek.
I didn't get all of that, but sure.
Selima wanga kun bikin.
You're hiding in the starship. It's your home, I understand.
Mucha shakapaka.
You said that before. What is gone Dyson?
Mucha shakapaka.
Something about me?
Dong abuk shami no nok.
It's something you like. Yes, gone Dyson means you like it?
Mucha shakapaka.
You like me, I understand.
Selima wanga kun bikin.
Na abds. You said that when I first found you.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
That means hit, is that it?
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
So abds means to hurt. No abds means not hurt, is that it?
Tonki ba non tontek.
I understand, I'm not going to hurt you.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Yum. What kind of word is that?
Dong abuk shami no nok.
It's a part of the ship. Is it a room?
Mucha shakapaka.
Yum means food. Yum is food.
Selima wanga kun bikin.
Numgis. Is that all one phrase?
Kipuna. Bonana kichu.
The floor? Nugis means floor.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
You're not speaking now. Nugis means now, nanugis is not now or before?
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
You want some food. You're hungry now.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Tabbed you. What do you mean?
Mucha shakapaka.
I'm supposed to talk, to speak. About what?
Tonki ba non tontek.
So, tabbed means tell me about. I get it.
Tonki ba non tontek. Mucha shakapaka.
Why are you hiding on the ship, Sasha?
Selima wanga kun bikin.
You came to the ship before. You were very scared. Why?
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
You left the Mandalorians and hid on the ship?
Tonki ba non tontek.
You don't want to leave. The Ebon Hawk is your home.
Dong abuk shami no nok.
The Ebon Hawk is not your home, Sasha. Not your first home, anyway.
Dong abuk shami no nok.
Tell me about your home before.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Dantooine. Maybe someone on Dantooine will remember you.
Got something on your mind, do you?
Why did you decide to come with me?
You got yourself a fast little ship? I forgot what engine sounded like. The closest thing to that on Kashyyyk is an Ulleran mating season. Frightful.
So you just wanted to ride on my ship?
Or it could be for the free food. What's the gunk that comes out of the synthesizer on this bucket anyway? Do you never clean the darn thing?
No, seriously, tell me.
I'm old, dammit. I'm allowed to be enigmatic when I want to be. And don't you go telling me otherwise. You know, you remind me of someone else I knew ages ago. Pleasant enough fellow, great destiny, all of that. Breath like a bantha.
Is that a comment on my breath?
No, but it could be. An Anduvian salt tablet would clear that right up, you know. Anyway, where was I? Oh, yes. Andor Vix was his name. The Force swirled around him like a hurricane. That's how great his destiny was.
I've never heard of him.
No, you wouldn't have. Sometimes swirling force is just swirling force. It gets us old Jedis excited at our age, so we go, ooh, destiny. Well, it turned out that poor Andor believed a wee bit too much in the infallibility of that destiny. That overconfidence turned out to be his downfall.
Is there supposed to be some hidden meaning in this?
I don't know. Are you overconfident? I hadn't noticed. Even if I had, I would never comment on it. We're talking about Andor, remember? Let's see. Oh yes, Andor's downfall. I was pretty young myself when it happened. At the time, I thought that Andor's destiny couldn't be more boring.
How young are we talking?
Well, let's just say that I was a strapping young lad with a full head of hair, and Coruscant was a small town with a well. I was just about to abandon Andor to whatever the Force intended for him when his ship was overtaken by a Dimian warship. Now, you've probably never heard of the Dimians. But at the time, they were a nasty lot led by a nastier overlord named Krat. Tall fellow, big teeth. Krat has us hauled onto the bridge of his ship for questioning, and that's when I knew that Andor's destiny was at hand.
How did you know?
Swirling force, remember? Jedi here. Granted, I was just interpreting the signs, but we get trained in that sort of thing, more or less. Well, Andor decides that his destiny makes him invulnerable and starts making all sorts of demands. Free me now. I'm not answering questions. Blah, blah, blah. Don't you know who I am? Yeah. Krat decides he's had enough and begins crushing Andor's neck. I told the boy he should have kept his mouth shut. I think he agreed, too. Or those could have just been gurgling noises. Well, anyway. Finally, Krat has enough of Andor and tosses him aside into this giant energy intake shaft. Andor gets sucked in and starts bouncing around, screaming. Maybe Andor hit something sensitive on the way down or just didn't agree with the reactor core. Next thing I know, all the ship's alarms are ringing.
You're kidding.
Everyone panics and I run, barely making it to the ship in time before the explosion. Krat dies horribly, and the Dimians never quite recovered. Changed the political course of the entire sector for centuries to come. I'd call that quite a destiny, wouldn't you?
Yeah. But what does that have to do with you coming with me?
Well, hey, the chances may not be great, but when one has the opportunity to see something like that twice in a lifetime. Anyway, go on. My throat is dry and you're making me cranky. Shoo!
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
I was wondering if we could talk.
What is it you would like to speak to me about?
Can you tell me more about your past?
Well, I suppose I have not talked very much about the Jedi I met back home. They, all of them, were so very invigorating.
Invigorating?
They were so very alive, so full of hope and energy and zeal. In retrospect, I can see it was a little bit tragic.
Tragic?
Well, yes. These Jedi were going to fight the Mandalorians just after they had invaded. Many of those Jedi perished in the fighting, but to us, they seemed invincible. Especially their leader, who they talked about all the time. Paragons of light and justice, sweeping away all iniquity before them. It was like looking at gods.
Jedi aren't gods.
I know that. I was using poetic license. But those Jedi, they were enthralling. Everyone wanted just to touch them. Some people thought it would bring them luck. Not that the peace they brought lasted very long.
Oh, what happened?
The Jedi left. The people grew complacent. Those who had been wronged saw their chance at revenge. And so the cycle continues. The oppressed become the new generation of oppressors. The human oppressed, that is. The non-humans were never treated well in any case. We felt the brunt of both administrations.
Was it that bad?
Of course it was. They took their frustrations and hate out on us because the people they wanted had already fled or were too well protected. But no one looks out for the injustices we suffered. Oh, no. But I am sorry. I should not have outbursts like that.
It's all right.
No, it is not. Anger can lead to the dark side, and I must be ever careful that I do not fall back into those ways. I thank you for your support. My outburst was uncalled for, but you did not lash back at me. You are a much better Jedi than I, it would seem. But let us not speak more of this now. We should continue on our journey. Perhaps later we will talk again.
I was wondering if you had any more war stories.
You want another war story, huh? You want to hear about some other world getting wasted, eh? I knew you were the type. Your stagnant republic has never seen some of the strange creatures and races we fought on the Outer Rim in those years. And you never will now.
What do you mean?
If a world isn't strong enough to defend itself, it's basically forfeit. But this story is about something a little different. We were going through the asteroid fields of the Crispin system at the very edge of the galaxy, playing with the pirates and smugglers we found there. The main belt in the Crispin system consists of mainly small rocks covered in frozen methane gas shells, and the pirates were using them for cover. Ha! I remember using a thermal generator to cause the outer layer of one of the asteroids to vaporize in a picosecond. It blew out and shredded the three smugglers using it for cover. But that was a mistake.
Why? What happened?
The asteroid I had targeted was smaller than most, maybe a dozen meters on the side. On the outside, it looked the same as any other, just a ball covered in frozen gas. But something must have been inside it, something inactive in the cold. The heat of my blast might have triggered something or woken something up. After I'd hit it, spots of light and heat appeared all over the thin shell, still covering it, evaporating the gases. What lay underneath looked like some sort of rocky growth. A deformed rock, pitted by scores of micrometeorite scars. I think something even older might have been inside that.
What happened next?
It started rotating faster and faster as we watched it. After a second, it started spraying fire, thermal projectiles that melted our armor like wax. We were caught completely by surprise. Before we could counterattack, it fled at an incredible speed.
You mean it was a ship?
We couldn't catch it, but we could follow its hyperspace wake. We followed its trail as far as we could, heading away from the galactic core. When it finally led beyond the edge of our galaxy, we abandoned our efforts. Anything that wants to commit suicide in that great void is not worth our trouble trying to catch. That's the only story I have for now. I'll tell you some more stuff later if we get the chance.
Alright, I'm thinking we are going to take Karth and Bastila out here onto the station with us. And I don't know what we're going to find. It doesn't look like we're on the planet itself. We came into some sort of station. Or ship or something above the planet. Well, the planet's a gas giant. Yavin's the moon, but we aren't even on the moon. So... and so far, it just looks like a lot of doors.
A chua penki yun patisa ti chuba ji kotka naga kingbu ki mulira kun king tong hitwama ak inko tune.
Open this door, I am your friend.
Ichuta yun patisa kingba nikcha lora kun. Ichuta.
All right, we got a Rodian up here with a pet Gizka. You want about 30 more of them? We got about 30 more you can have.
Topana ota vokasa, pampa ki mulira kun king. Changwaba chingyo shang achua penki, yun patisa. Dichuba ji kutka naga, kingbu mwa mulira duana.
I'm on a quest for the Jedi Council. I am a Jedi. What happened last time?
Tichuba ji kutka naga, kingbu mwa mulira duana. Kingba nikcha loka kincha nawabagaon. Bagwa shank konti machit
Enlighten me about Exar Kun.
Chiwi aita ka chong chicha. Agi inko tune chuna mulira. Tongi wama jikona. Tong kipa nonku nek abog. Tonghi wama ji aki inko tun. Kachopa bogra shanko tachicha. Chawa wish kun yun kun. Ogra shok chong kanti chopa chawa wish yun kun. Ti ompi du puta krita. Jiska dosoki, kopa bono nakachu. Labora na winky smack toma. Kuyami jusku chitanai.
You spend all of your time on this station? Alone?
Ki mulira kun king. Tong hit wama ag I inko tu. Chiwa aita kan ki cha na chupornibo kun muli ras limo poiwanga tong itwama ji.
You're an inventor.
Jiska dosoki, kopa bono nakachu, labora na winky smack toma, kuyami jusku chitanai, uchua penki, topa na oto bokasa, yubabato kanchi, chiwa aita kan ki cha na chupornibo.
Why exactly did you come to this station?
Jiska dosoki, kopa bono nakachu, labora na winky smack toma, kuyami jusku chitanai, uchua penki, topa na oto vokasa, yubabato kanchi, tong hit wama ag I inko tune, por tong hi wama ji ag I inko tun, tong pa no kun, no nek, chiwi aita ka chong chicha, ki mulira kun. Chiwi aita ka chong chicha. Agi inko tune chuna muri ra.
Do you have any gadgets that you might be willing to sell us?
Tong hit wama ag I inko tune. Por tong hi wama ji ag I inko tun. Tong pa no kun, no nek. Chiwi aita ka achua penki. Yun patisa. Tichuba ji kutka naga. Kingbu mwa muri ra duana. Kingba nikcha lora kun. Jiska dosoki, kopa bono nakachu, labora na winky smack toma, kuyami jusku chitanai ki mulira kun king. Tong hit wa-
Alright, wow, yes. He has quite expensive things. They are quite good things. Look at some of these. Wow, awareness 10. Immunity. Very good things. We don't have a lot of money, but I think we can sell some stuff, so I might do that and then see what we can afford. Alright, so we sold all of our extra items to him, and we actually had quite a few. We had like 20,000 credits by the end, and I bought a few good things. I bought the stabilizer gauntlets, which I'm going to give to Arran here, and those will give him more dexterity and more bolt deflection, which will be quite nice. I also bought him a quite advanced implant, which is going to give him more dexterity and awareness even. And then I bought some armor, which is not going to be for Arran, but here it is, the light exoskeleton, which gives a very high dexterity bonus, dexterity, strength, and is upgradable. So, but that is going to go probably to Karth for now. And it looks pretty cool in my opinion. So,
sure.
We are in good shape. We've bought stuff from this guy, and I guess it's time we can just get back on the Ebon Hawk, since that's all that there is here. So we're gonna get going. We're gonna make our way to the next planet, which I'm thinking we have Manon and Korriban. I think we're gonna take a little while to do a few side missions, though. We're gonna take Sasha back to Dantooine.
How can I help?
I'd like to know more about you, Bastila.
Yes, I suppose I can understand your curiosity, given the bond that connects us. Very well. I'll tell you a bit about myself.
Tell me about how you joined the Jedi, then.
I was found to be strong with the Force at a young age, as most Padawans are. As a girl, I was given to the Order to be trained. When I joined the Order, I left my family on Talravan, as all Padawans do. My family is still there, the last that I heard. I've had little contact with them, as it is discouraged.
Discouraged? Why?
Relationships with family members are fraught with powerful emotions. Such extremes are to be avoided. Anger and hate are the worst, but even love can lead to folly.
You aren't allowed to love?
Emotional entanglements can be dangerous. They can impair rational thought. They can lead to outbursts of uncontrolled emotion. A Jedi must be above such things.
You don't sound very convinced.
It can be a hard lesson to learn. I was not on good terms with all of my family, but I do remember missing my father terribly for a long time.
Who weren't you on good terms with?
I was not on good terms with my mother. I was only a little girl when I left, but I was old enough to resent her and the way she treated my father. She pushed my father into treasure hunting. I spent all my young life on ships, traveling from one false lead to the next. She whittled away my father's entire fortune, and I hated her for it. I think she was relieved to give me to the Jedi, but my father was heartbroken. A child is too young to understand the sacrifices that must be made. It's better if they have no contact with their family once they're removed. Once I was older, I realized the wisdom of this policy. A Jedi must do what is needed, personal desires notwithstanding. Love can only obscure and confuse the matter.
You sound very sad when you say that.
Even a Jedi cannot always control the feelings of the heart. We must do our best to guard against it, no matter what the cost. But some sacrifices are harder than others. I do not wish to discuss this anymore. I would rather return to our mission.
So, yes, we have, not Tatooine, what do we have here? We have Korriban, where there is still a star map hiding. We have Manon. And then we'll have all of them. But I think before we get too overwhelmed with that, we're going to take a little bit of time to do some of our side missions. Notably, we're going to take Sasha home. At least I think this is her home. She seemed to know where Dantooine was. Hopefully someone there will recognize her and know her family. So that's where we're headed.
HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
I'd like to try restoring more of your memory.
Affirmative. If you believe your skills are up to the task, Master, then I can certainly guide you through the process. Request. I only ask that you be oh so very careful, Master. I am too valuable and well-crafted to perish at the hands of ineptitude.
Fine, let's get started.
Statement. As you wish, Master. The first stage is the simple one. And that is accessing my central control cluster. This may take a while. First, you will need to open 3 panels. And now rewire the last 3 relays. Yes, good. Well done, Master. I believe your operation was a success. Accessing new memory. Access complete. I have recovered information on my owner previous to the commercial officer, Master. Intriguing.
What's so intriguing?
Statement. It appears that my previous owner was a human senator on the planet Coruscant. A man of importance who obviously appreciated quality craftsmanship.
How did he get a hold of you?
Answer. I am unsure, Master. Any knowledge of my owner prior to him is still deleted. The senator did assume I was a protocol droid, however. I do remember that I was very pleased to be the property of a senator. One of his assistants discovered my assassination functions later through questioning. The assistant was quite alarmed and told the senator I should be scrapped quickly to avoid a scandal. Naturally, the senator had me eliminate the fool.
So we're not talking about a nice senator, then. I see.
Observation. Senators are not nice, Master. They are either on top of the game or yesterday's news. My master told me that frequently, you see. I was most proud to have partaken in the political system of the galaxy. During the time my owner possessed me, he gained significant rank. Given time, I believe he could have become Chancellor. I even eliminated a few key opponents that he did not ask for. Freebies, if you will.
You can do that?
Answer. Certainly. Why not? I am an intelligent droid, you know. I see an opportunity, and I take it. And my master was most pleased with my work. Observation. I think he would have done far better had he not allowed his use of me to become personal. He set me on his wife.
Why would he do that?
Answer. I am unsure. The human was most agitated and angry. I believe his wife had done something that had displeased him greatly. I was to go to their summer estate and terminate his wife, along with whatever male companion I discovered there.
Ah, so his wife was cheating on him.
Statement. I have no idea, Master. Cheating seems to be a relevant term only when one is caught in the act. Otherwise, it is viewed as intelligence. No? I journeyed to the southern continent, but it appeared my master was not far behind me. Apparently, he regretted his activation of the protocol. When I found the wife and her companion, I proceeded to launch my attack, but my master interposed his own body and was destroyed. It was rather a strange meatbag thing to do you not agree? Naturally, I shut myself down, my master being terminated.
So that's 2 out of 2 masters killed.
Observation. Only so far, Master. There are still more memories not recovered, remember?
What happened to you then?
Statement. I believe the senator's wife was unsure what I was or what to do with me. It was she who sold me to the corporate officer, an acquaintance.
Have you recovered any more memories?
Answer. As previously, I have found a few more programs which will enhance my performance. A most gratifying discovery, in fact. There is still nothing from previous memories uncovered. You will have to operate again if you desire to find them. With luck, I will discover the stimulus to unlock my core, and all this will be unnecessary. I do thank you for the attempt, however, Master.
Excuse me, have you seen a mechanic about? Short fellow, bald, I've been looking.
Well, I'll be a Wookiee's uncle. Davin? Davin Cochris?
Jolie? Jolie Pinto? Why, you old freak. Last time I saw you, you were still wandering the galaxy in that old tug. I thought you were dead, old man.
I crashed somewhere and decided to stay.
Yeah. I'll just bet. Damn, old man, you look exactly the same as the last time I saw you. You pickle well.
You're too kind. Not the young lad anymore yourself, I see.
Care to introduce your friend, Jolie?
What are you, deaf? His name's Davin. Old friend from my Wanderer days. By the by, Davin, I really should be running off.
Of course, old man. Wait. If you've been traveling in this sector, I suppose you heard about Sunri?
No, why? What's there to hear?
He's been picked up by the Selkath authorities on Manan. For murder.
That's preposterous.
I know. Alora is beside herself, as you can imagine. Maybe you could help them. I'm sure Sunri would appreciate a Jedi's assistance right about now.
Perhaps I will at that. It's up to my friend here, actually. I'm just tagging along.
We can check in on it. We're going to Manan soon.
I'd appreciate that. Sunri's an old friend. I'd hate to see him hurt.
Same here. Well, it was good to see you again. Give my regards to Alora if you see her.
I will. Be safe, old friend.
All right, so we need to find someone who knows Sasha. And I've never seen this door. What's behind it here?
Achuta, wonga kun bis dolpi kikuyana, dong patugas makdelia. Runda di hotonga kun honka di, wana kun be.
Jeda ba dwana ni di bobo. Dong na bungsha nununya, dong patuga.
Ka chi kun ita hotonga, yikin kuno ba mulera chi kun. Slimo podon
Achuta. Wonga kun bis dolpi kikuyana, dong patugas makdelia.
Yes, we've heard about Circa Corp before. I think I'll be going.
Runda di hotonga kun hunka bi. Wana kun bez ching palamul.
Tong hai tuam jiji yumalith pa ang inko tu. Tolba da bunko.
I'll be going.
Mucha.
Okay, neither of them know about Sasha. A lot of green Twi'leks around here.
Yikukuno noba mulira chikun. Tong hith kun chonchi.
Go ahead.
Chi gratu loda bograshi onio kompa chintono mochuba. Loda dita kun. Ida patiso batu.
Ka chi kun ida hodonga. Ye king kuno ba mulera chi kun. Slimo podona.
There's a stowaway on my ship by the name of Sasha.
Jeda baduana ni di bobo. Dong na bungsha nununya. Dong patuka shmak.
You can come aboard and see her if you like. Yes, I am. She only speaks a smattering of Mandalorian, but I've been able to figure it out.
Runda di hotonga kun hunkabi. Wana kun bez ching palamule tongking ba nunotek.
Certainly, I'll bring you to my ship.
Achuta, wonga kun bis dolpi kikuyana, dong patugas mak.
Runda di hotonga kun hankabi, wana kun bez ching palamule tongking ba nunotek. Tuk nin chatukune mulerabes.
Mucho shakapanga.
Tolpa da pongwale gandu nangu chuchut. Kavadum ku pilio botenya. Bonanai kuchu. Hawaga poska chocola. Mucha shakpanga.
Kipuna. Bonanakichu.
Takum juz dach miki grabal mogo. Kachi ita hodunga.
Tong abuk shami no nok.
Lur aka na bads nun gisa lefsa Sasha.
Tong ki ba non tontek slimo wanga kun bikin.
Tong hait wam jiji jum lumpa. Nita poe tikitu. Dolpa da bongwaleo gandona chuchut. Kachi chu ita dundoga.
How can I help?
You wish to talk to me?
I do. I've been watching you, studying you closely to see what kind of progress you've made since your training at the hands of Master Zar.
I think we both know the real reason you're watching me.
You never give up, do you? I admit, I'm interested in you. I find you intriguing, compelling even, but it's not what you think. You have a great gift. You have an awesome command of the Force, and I tremble when I think of how you might misuse it.
I make you tremble? You get all tingly inside, too.
What? No, of course not. Not like that, anyway. In many ways, you are dangerous. You could be the savior of the galaxy, or you could bring untold destruction upon us all. I've seen how you've resisted many temptations and continue to walk the path of the light side. Very commendable, but I'm afraid you might stray from this path. You need to see what the dark side represents in its entirety, for it is what we battle. Only the wisdom of a Jedi Master can truly explain this, but I will do my best to make you understand.
What are you trying to tell me?
The dark side is not simply giving in to anger, temptation, or to use the Force to destructive ends. These things only lead to the dark side. The dark side grows stronger and more insidious the closer you draw to it. It begs you to surrender to it, to release all its terrible power, and it becomes harder and harder to resist. And once you stop resisting, it's too late. It twists you up inside and turns you into a mockery of everything you once stood for.
You seem to know about that temptation very well.
I am no less resistant to temptation than any other. I simply have the benefit of training that you do not. But even the training of the Jedi might not be enough to save us. We need only to look at the atrocities which have been committed by those under its sway to understand the terrible, corrupting evil of the dark side. Millions dead, and far more suffering. What sort of person would you have to become to perform such deeds gladly?
I don't think I could ever see myself doing such things.
That is why the dark side is so insidious. If you are not careful, you do not even see each small step you take towards it until it's too late. It's so easy to think that we would never fall prey to such a horror, that we have unlimited control, vigilance, and foresight. If only that were true. The Sith have become powerful because there are many Jedi who've succumbed to the lure of the dark side and joined their cause. What greater weapon is there than to turn an enemy to your cause, to use their own knowledge against them? We are weakened while they are strengthened, so we must harden our hearts and do whatever is required to fight against the dark side, even when the battle becomes wearying.
Such as?
I don't know. The vision of our future is clouded by shadows cast from the dark side. But I sense something ominous lurking in those shadows. But words alone cannot save one from the dark side. Come, we should continue with the task at hand. When the time comes, I only hope we are all strong enough to do what we must.
All right. Well, that was the only business we needed to attend to on Dantooine. Now, we need to go to Manon for the star map, and Jolie has that friend there that apparently is on trial. That's a priority. We're definitely going there before we go to Korriban now. However, I do have one little mission with, well, a mission with mission that we need to do on Tatooine. So we're going to pop over there, and I'm thinking that's where we're going to head next, and hopefully we can get that taken care of fairly quickly.